have a dollar alcohol.
For over 20 years now, Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries, and Parks has been gathering data on our black bear population here in the state. This past year has been focused more on southeast and southwest Mississippi, trying to gather genetic data and collaring data. This past summer has been no different.
We're on a collaborative project with MSU, so we're trapping and collaring bears in southwest Mississippi. Today we're in Claiborne County, and this is our seventh bear. Let's see, I think it's our ninth bear total of this project. So this makes nine in southwest Mississippi, makes a total of 17 altogether. And what this is, you know, one of the questions I get asked all the time is how many bears do we have in Mississippi? And so this project and others like it, the hair snare project is the same way. We're trying to get good estimates of numbers and find out more about this population, particularly in southwest, it's not quite as studied.
All right, let's get some ice on her.
So the bear program is unique in the fact that it's really one of the last conservation stories that we're able to fulfill. So we've had the white-tailed deer, the eastern wild turkey, and you know the black bear is just following that same trajectory. And so to be a part of that, you know, possibly building that population to a point where it could sustain harvest is just the coolest thing in the agency as far as I'm concerned. So we've had some pretty good success. We've trapped a few bears and gotten some more collars out. So all that data is getting GPS information, and we're going to use that to look at things like habitat, home range, den site selection, all those things that we can monitor through that research. And then we have the genetic research that we're doing. That's going to really give us an idea, hopefully in the future, of things like density, population estimate, and all the things that people want to know about bears. This year, particularly this past summer, I've experimented with a lot of different types of baits, a lot of preferences that different bears had in certain areas. You know, I've seen bears walk right past a bag of donuts to go, you know, hit a corn feeder. It's a lot of trial and error and just figuring out what works and making little adjustments until you get it just right.
There's a window you can fold down and it gives you 3 inches of clearance. That hole back there is 10 by 10, so you gotta be careful because they can get a paw out there, yeah. When I went to shoot, I'm good.
Darn it.
Yep. I was gonna try to get his back end, and his arm was down like this, and it threw me off because I was getting ready to see a big hindquarter, and then his arm was in the way, so I had to change. There was some injection, but I don't know how much. We'll see how he reacts to it.
Our two goals can basically be boiled down in the bear program as number one, public education, and then number two, research. And so we want to, number one, increase the public's knowledge, number one, that we have black bears in the state, and then number two, how to live, you know, responsibly and avoid as much conflict as possible. And then, you know, to build on that research that, again, we've already been doing for 20 years now, to a point where we have a good solid estimate of what that population is, and then start making decisions on what management, you know, seasons should be in place or you know, what that next step will be, and how to make those decisions as informed as we can.
He's pale. We need to get some O2 started quick. All right, one, two, three. One more heave. One, two, three. All right. We're gonna use this to move him. So we're gonna pull him out onto this mat and then bring him over here, start the oxygen, start all that stuff. Now all we gotta do is pick him up and carry him all the way over there. We're gonna take him like right here and work him up. Well, that way, as the sun's coming up, we still got shade. It'll take most of us. We've got ear tags, we got pit tag, we've got a handful of measurements, we're up on vitals. We still need weight, we still need paw and height and all that kind of stuff, total length and all that. I'm going to get the head measurements. 11. Yeah, 33 is what I have for forearm length. Looks like a dang arm wrestler. He's still taking good deep breaths though. All right, chest is gonna be 123. That's gonna be about right. So, all right, does it tear it out? All right, that's it.
Oh, wow, okay.
384.
All right, let him back down. This is an adult male we trapped in this morning. He looks to be a young adult, about average body size for this area, and just a big, pretty male, and we're glad he's gonna be getting some data for us.
She said, oh, don't worry.
Usually the first thing that we do once we get the animal stabilized is we'll put the GPS collar on, and that's so if we don't get anything else done, that's properly fitted and it's transmitting that data. So this is one of our GPS collars. These are the kind that we're putting out right now. So down here we've got, this is mostly comprising the battery case and some of the electronics here that receives the programming. And up here we've got the actual GPS unit that tells where the bear is, so it sends those points to us electronically over a satellite. And then of course obviously this is for sizing here, and then this is what we call a blow off or a pop off, and at a specific time and date this is programmed to have a small charge in there that pops this off and allows the collar to fall off so we can go recover it. We also put a leather spacer in between these two where that way even if for some reason that pop off fails, that leather will eventually rot off after roughly a year, and we'll be able to recover that collar that way so it doesn't pose a risk to the bear. And then we also give them some unique markings. So we give them identification tags on their ears. Those go through their ears. And then we also have what's called a pit tag, which is an electronic tag that's about the size of a grain of rice that we can use to scan. And we can identify that individual, whether it was tagged as a cub or as an adult. The pit tag goes here roughly in between the shoulder blades, between the neck and shoulders, and that way everybody knows where to scan. So one of the first things that we do when we find, when we trap a bear, is we'll scan this area right here to see if we have any prior data on this or if it's an initial capture.
Hey.
Hey. Y'all got one?
You're the other bear?
Of course. I mean, it's nice and cool today. That trap's in the shade. I'm already in Claiborne. That'll be another hour and a half, but I mean you're probably looking at 2 or 3 hours getting down there, so I can be down there if you want to wait.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, I'll call you back whenever I get this one worked up. We got one bear down, we got one bear in Wilkinson County in a trap. The future of the black bear program is really bright. You know, we want to build on the 20 years plus of research that we've already done. We want to continue to expand that knowledge base, and then we also want to expand the public interest and the public awareness so that we can all live as responsibly with black bears as we can. So we're down here in Wilkinson County. We've got another bear sedated. We're down here with the grad students from MSU. This is part of the same project, but it's in a different part of the state. And so this one, we're going to actually go ahead and GPS collar, do a full workup. Get around there. Obviously any wild animal can be dangerous, but black bears want to avoid conflict as much as they can. One of the common misnomers I hear repeated is, you know, the most dangerous animal out there is a sow with cubs. And, you know, we do den checks every year where I get feet from a sow nursing her cubs in the den. And, you know, when it comes down to it, they just want to avoid conflict and they just want to go their separate ways. Hey, bear. Yep. We'll be right back.
We want to build on the education, the public education, the awareness of black bears in the state, how to live responsibly with bears, and then also to build on the research that my predecessors had done such a great job doing and to relay that information to the public so we can all be as informed as we can.
I think that's going to be pretty close.
Basically, we've only seen bears once or twice, but we get a lot of pictures on our game cameras. But actually seeing them, that's the second one I've ever seen on the property. Well, the department contacted us, and we absolutely had no problem with that. We're kind of conservationists. We don't even kill many deer here. But no, it was no problem, and they were very wonderful to work with. It gets really complicated when they get them out of the trap, but it was just all very interesting, and I'd encourage anybody that ever gets a chance to do it to go watch it.
She's got pit tags, she's got ear tags, collar. The more that we find the different habitats that they can make a living in, the places that they turn up are in more and more surprising areas, and you know, that's part of the reason why we're having such a big push for public education is because there's more and more people throughout the state that are going to have to sort of go through those mental, you know, checklist to just adjust to living with bears in their area.
Should be up soon.
Starting to come around.
Yeah, once that first movement starts,
no time. There we go. All at once.
And it's that fast. We're constantly trying to build on our research. So if there's anybody out there that sees bears regularly on their place, we encourage you to either report that on our website, mdwfp.com, and go to the Black Bear Program. Or you can give our office a call if it's something that you're interested in us coming out and doing some trapping possibly. You know, we'd be glad to participate in that.
Hey y'all, thanks for watching this episode of Mississippi Outdoors.
We hope you enjoyed this video.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out other videos from previous seasons.
And don't forget to ring the bell for notifications so you don't miss out on future shows.